Hi everyone, I'm Jamina, and welcome to the fourth video. In this video, I'm going to start putting everything together in Adobe Premiere Pro, so let's jump right into it. I'm going to pick my start image. I'm going to pick the one with all the lights on. I'm going to pick this one with all the lights on by hitting Control C to copy. Now making sure all the other tracks are locked, except the one that I'm working on. Otherwise, I'd select and move them also, and I only want to move the clips on this track. I'm going to hit Z for the track selection tool and select everything to the right of the tool. Then I'm going to hit B for the move tool and move all the clips on the track over so I can put the image I want in the beginning of the video by hitting Control V to paste it. Z for the track selection tool, V for the move tool, and I move everything out of the way. Now I'm going to extend this clip. Now I'm going to unlock this layer and extend the clip of the boots. Let me lock this layer, which is the main image of the room I worked on in the last video. Now I'm going to add a layer and move the boots up so I can add some water on the floor under them. Let me import the clips of the water, which are 3D objects, just like the boots, the fire logs that are by the fireplace, the telescope, and the TV over the fireplace, all of which came from Envato Elements. Now that I've imported the clips of the water, I'm going to load them onto the track I just added by dragging them on. Let me resize it and slide it under the boot. I'm going to click on the boot clip to copy the brightness and contrast and the drop shadow effect and paste it onto the puddle of water clip. Now I'm going to adjust the brightness. I'm adding another track so I can move the second puddle of water up onto it above the first one. Now I'm going to resize it, slide it under the boot, just like the first one. The effects that I copied from the boots are still on the clipboard, so I'm going to paste them onto this clip of the puddle of water. I'm not going to adjust the brightness of this one because I think it's okay. Let me extend these clips. I'm put in a crossfade on the beginning of the clips of water so they'll fade in and they'll look like there's water dripping off the boot. I want one puddle to appear right after the other one, so I'm just arranging these the way I want them. Extend the puddles of water. I'm going to select all of these and just push them forward. I also added a crossfade to the end as I want it to look like the water is drying. I'm going to extend these some more. Then I'm going to select them all and slide them where I want the boots to appear in the video. I might change this later, but for right now, this is where I'm going to keep the boots. I'm satisfied with the boots. So I'm going to lock these layers. I always try to remember to lock layers that I'm not working on. Now on to the cat. Let me unlock that layer so I can work on it. Let me ungroup these so I can work on these clips individually. I'm gonna adjust the brightness on the cat because it's laying under the light and it should not be this dark. I'm gonna select these clips and I'm gonna delete them. Now I'm going to make a copy of the one I changed the brightness on by holding Alt, clicking the clip, and dragging it. I'm going to make a copy of the clip that I changed the brightness on by clicking on it and hitting Ctrl C. Then I'm going to paste them by hitting Ctrl V. Now I'm going to select these four and make copies of those. I have to unlock the runes layer. I'm going to undo that hitting Ctrl Z because it overlapped. I'm going to select all of these and move them back out of the way and continue pasting. Now I'm going to choose the room with the lamp off over the couch. Put a crossfade between the two and extend it. Now I'm looking to see exactly where the light shuts off. I'm going to grab these two clips, delete them. Let me lock this layer because I'm no longer working on it. Now I'm just checking to make sure no other layers are unlocked. Now back on the cat layer, I'm gonna hit Z, selecting all the clips to the right, right click and hit ripple delete, and it'll close that gap. Now let's see what it looks like. See how the light comes on the cat? And the light goes off. There's a gap somewhere. Or no, that fade. The wrong kind of fade. Let me fix that. I'm gonna delete that. And add a crossfade. Now I'm just gonna shorten it up a bit. Now let's see what it looks like. And it fades much better. See that? However, the cat right here is light. I need to fix that. So I'm gonna highlight this, hit C, get the cutting tool, and delete it. Right click and hit ripple delete, closing that gap. Now let's take a look at it. Let me line these clips up, right click, hit ripple delete. Let me ungroup these layers so I can work on them. I'm going to extend this clip of the room with the lights out. Now let's see what it looks like. And that is the end of this video. Although I'm going to continue working on this, I'm going to end the video here. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next video, where I'll be back in Photoshop creating some 3D elements for the video. See you then.